With school out, kids may have a new schedule or lack thereof, and there's a ton of time for them to snack.
Mm-hmm. Registered nutritionist Leanne Phillipson joins us once again this morning with food and recipe suggestions that are packed with essential nutrients to keep your kids focused and full all day long. Good to see you, Leanne. How have you been?
Oh, so great to see you. I'm doing good, thank you. Yeah, really good. Doing lots and lots of cooking.
Listen, we keep talking about the quarantine 15. After 3 days home and cooking and eating everything I cooked, everything's tighter this morning. So I don't know how people are managing. And little ones, you need to feed their brains.
Mm-hmm. They do. And also parents, you know, the kids are at home and now they're realizing they can't really focus very well. Maybe there's outbursts, maybe there's meltdowns, maybe their sleep is all over the place too.
Yeah.
So to talk about focus, because that's really the biggest pain point that I see from a lot of parents, and they never stop asking for snacks. So let's focus on some snacks today. So for their focus and also to help their mood, they need foods that are going to keep them going. So here I've got just a banana. Chop it in half, throw on some homemade granola. Of course, in my book, Sprout Right Family Food, I've got lots of ideas there. And the granola recipe, some blueberries, a little bit of peanut butter, almond butter, something like that. These sneaky little muffins have got grated carrot and zucchini in them.
Yum.
So they're not going to know, but also the chia seeds, the fiber really helps to keep them going. And who doesn't love like some frozen yogurt? So this is some great berries that just go into the frozen yogurt. And then when the kids are saying, I just want to eat more, I just want to eat more, and they never stop. You know, they never stop going. And you just want them also to stay strong and to help that focus. Mm-hmm. Then this is the carrot spread with some, just with some crackers. Maybe you could get some veggies going on with some hummus. You know, these are really, really easy things. And then also look at this cute little pot of chia pudding that I made up. Chia pudding is the easiest thing to do. You can make these up, just stack them into, you know, put them in the fridge and then have at it, kids, because parents don't always want to be going to the kitchen again, because when you go to the kitchen again, then you're going to grab a snack for yourself. So then there's also the last thing that I want to touch on is the guilt that we feel. So when you say, please, 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 I'm in the middle of a conference call. You're asking for the 100th snack of the day. I just want you to go and get something for yourself. So how about you get your kids to make some of the Go Faster granola bars? This is such a staple recipe in my book. These are Rice Krispie squares. There's no marshmallows in them. It's just all nut butters, so really keeps them going. These actually are my cookies, which I messed up. These are chocolate chip cookies that sort of turned into something new, and that's fun for them to do. But you make these in the blender, then you pour them out onto the baking tray. They can make those. And how easy is it just to throw some yogurt into a bowl with some granola and a few berries? So these really, really help to keep them going, and that's the point. And also to ease the parents' stress. It's just such a crazy time. The structure needs to be there, but it's not always, so that's okay. And, you know, parents, we do feel guilty because we want to give them the foods that they need, but we're frazzled ourselves. So I put together a guide of 21 snacks for all sorts of different situations. So you can go to sproutright.com/focus. This here is the first page. I've just printed it out. You just download it. There's all sorts of snacks. I've got loads of videos on YouTube. I've been cooking every single day at 5 o'clock on Sprout Right's Facebook page and Instagram page. So there's loads and loads of ideas and recipes. There's even some fun ones of my daughter, my 14-year-old daughter, making things like the Rice Krispie squares too. And she's a hoot. Like she makes anything. she drops everything everywhere.
Swedish chef style.
It's such a blast. She made some muffins and promptly poured all the chocolate chips everywhere and then just made her way through it. So it's perfect for kids to watch because they realize that nothing's perfect. You don't have to be perfect, but enjoy the food because it's actually really, really super, super tasty food. So you can go to sproutright.com/focus, grab that guide. And I'm actually also doing a workshop for parents tomorrow at 4 o'clock too. So I'm just giving as much as I possibly can just to support everybody through this because it's such a crazy time.
Yeah, and we need the ideas.
Yeah, we do. And you know, it's good for the kids, of course, but it's going to help out the adults. And I think I'm going to check that out too for some more. And it's okay to be messy in the kitchen.
Totally.
People got to realize that. It's okay to make a mess while you get that stuff. So Leanne, thank you so much.
Thanks, Leanne. Stay well. Love to you
and
the kids.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks,
you too.
We'll be back with more BT right after this. That'll look delicious.
So good.
Would you enjoy it?